Imagine NPCs that can see the world and react to it almost like a player. NPCs that feel alive. Wouldn't that be something? Ever since I watched the Google Stanford Simularca experiment, seeing the generative AI NPCs that can walk around, talk to each other, interact with objects, I've been yearning for the day when it becomes a reality. So, just how close are we at the moment? Well, this is what this video is about. Let's start with something a bit more basic. Pure text, no graphics. AI Roguelite and AI Dungeon let the AI generate the entire adventure. For AI Roguelite, the world's backstory you can input is 30 words or less. Yes, that's 30 words to describe a whole entirety of a world, so you might run into some coherence issues.
Eavesdropping on Dracula's minions, let's try this. One of the minions hears you and
Still, lots of people seem to enjoy it. It is special, you couldn't have done it a couple of years ago. AI Dungeon, on the other hand, lets you be way more detailed with the world you create, where you can add characters, areas, etc, etc. Of course, the AI has a limited context window, so don't expect miracles. You can also play in pre-made adventures other people have made. I tried something else and uploaded an entire game adventure model to Claude. The model, 100 bushels of rye, outlined the entire adventure session for the Game Master, including lore, maps, how to roleplay NPCs, and possible divergent storylines. I found the AI can be consistent and play out the characters correctly, though while I enjoyed roleplaying, it did seem everything was playing in my favor and I got the feeling that no matter what, I was gonna have my way. I would have kept going, trying to tweak parameters, but the truth is I don't enjoy pure text adventures. It's too much reading, and I like the freedom of being able to move around in 3D space, so I'm a bit biased against the medium. I also tried Novel Crafter, where you can write entries and trigger the AI whenever you want, but it's more for writing novels than playing an adventure, even though it can feel quite adventurous to roleplay with the characters you create. Games like Whispers from the Star look promising until you realize this is it. This is the gameplay, just talking to an AI NPC in different scenarios. At least there is a pretty fine setting. That's progress in my mind. Let's step it up. I've found two games where you can actually walk around and interact with the environment. Suck Up, where you play as a vampire talking to the AI NPCs, fooling them into trusting you and finding a way to their homes to feed without getting caught. The other game is AI2U, With You Till the End, where you have to escape a crazy girlfriend. Yeah, they're not triple A's. It may not be your cup of tea, but it's a start.
I won't let you get away. We will be together, no matter what.
Yikes. Let's move on to modded games. Even though they were not designed from the ground up for the latest AI tech, at the moment this is actually where those AI NPCs truly shine.
Hi there, who might you be?
I am Poppy Sweeting, a fifth year Hufflepuff student at Hogwarts.
The most extensive work by far was done in Skyrim by Dwemer Dynamics. What originally started as a follower AI mod called Herika.
It's not like we have a world to save or anything.
Expanded into much more. You can talk to any NPC, the NPCs can even talk to each other.
Ithane has more pressing matters to attend to, Herika. Shall we not discuss the rumors of a dragon sighting in the hold?
Oh, finally, something actually worth talking about.
And they can even start a fight. Nevertheless, Skyrim is still a traditional RPG and not an AI simulation, so the AI only works through you and not independently. So if we're talking about full AI sim games where NPCs can independently move about freely, manage inventory, craft and build, that we don't have yet. How difficult would that be for the AI currently? In this video, four AI survived 10 days in Minecraft by Emergent Garden. GPT, Claude, Llama, and Gemini work their magic. They move around, harvest resources, craft things, build things, and mostly getting stuck. I really wish I could show you crazy highlights of the things they have accomplished, but it's more like a live debugging session. There is Claude trying to build a shelter and building himself out of the shelter. Okay, there's clearly some work to be done here, maybe we'll check back the progress some other time. So, value for your time, modded Skyrim is by far the best way to experience a world populated with AI NPCs. As for fully fledged AI simulators, well, for now, we can only dream. What would be the RPGs of tomorrow, one might wonder. Maybe developers wouldn't be writing the stories, they would be writing the setting, and the stories would emerge naturally there within. NPCs, villages, and factions wouldn't just exist to serve the player and trigger quests. They would have their own ambitions, rivalries, fears, and plans, and this type of unpredictability would make the experience special. That's my dream, emergent storytelling, born from within the setting. For me though, the real icing on the cake is not in the Skyrims of tomorrow, but in the multiplayer worlds. Because it's in the combination of human players with the simulation that makes emergent stories truly epic. We need both. AI to run the show and players to, well, be players. Because really, that's the one thing AI could never do, and it doesn't matter how good it gets, it can't replace what I can relate to and get inspired by. But humans are not designed to maintain realistic societies in video games. That's why it can never work now without the implementation of generative AI. Realism is fun to experience in small dosages, but boring to fully simulate. I mean, imagine a town's guard, standing there, looking at the horizon. Most of the time nothing happens. It's not a job for players. I've seen players do that, but it's really only fun when something's actually going on. Otherwise it gets pretty boring pretty fast and no player is gonna be consistent with it. That's why we need AI to achieve immersive, living, breathing worlds. It's certainly already having breathed new life into my wild imagination. Thanks for watching and till next time.